Oh, Evil Harry Dredd. Hi, how's it going, man?
Oh, you've been watching me.
He has been.
Hey.
He's been diligently watching you, diligently preparing.
I've been planning a little bit since I had to plan for some things.
Some things, some stuff.
Evil Harry Dredd. We are playing Out of the Abyss. Sean is just working late. So, because his character doesn't use gold or shop, really, he said that his character will just diligently follow us around, casting guidance on us anytime we need to make a check.
That's right. We're going to buy one shiny thing for a couple coppers.
Yeah. Because he didn't want anything, and we wanted to do some shopping. And rather than take up time next time we play Storm King's Thunder, we figure, why not get all that stuff out of the way now?
So let's do it.
Look at that, opened right up to Tower of Zephyros.
And then, honestly...
Man, do I want to steal everything in that chest.
I just want to use the 26 days to get to Bryn Shander to make a magic item, because that's what it takes.
Oh, yeah?
8-hour days. 25 8-hour days.
If we're just flying.
And some gold.
And some gold. Yeah. We have all that. All right, so... Here we are in the Tower of Zephyros, and now I'm in character.
All right.
I decided, because Sean's doing a deeper voice for Strix, I don't want to be the same voice, so I'm still going to keep...
Sometimes.
It gets close, so I'm just going to keep the monotone, but I'm just going to keep my deadpan monotone...
Normal voice.
Because I can't really do, like, an elven-y... I mean, he's drow, I don't know.
Also, that seems pretty drowish.
Yeah.
Whatever.
You know,
things happen.
It's fine. Zephyros over here. The cloud giant is a spellcaster. He's been doing some contacting planes and other stuff. He's got wispy hair, is sleeping, but pretty sure you guys asked him to take you to Waterdeep.
Yes,
indeed. Did you guys actually travel to Waterdeep, and that's where we ended?
We were on the way.
We were an hour outside of Waterdeep when we ended.
All right, so
we didn't want him to get in trouble, so we were stopping an hour outside to ride in normally on our horses.
All right, so you're able to land somewhere in the forest outside of Waterdeep.
Okay.
And Zephyros is like, well, be safe.
All right.
Don't dilly-dally.
We won't.
All right. We have important stuff to talk about.
Okay. Yes, of course.
We're not silly sallies.
We don't
dilly dally.
Good. This is good. And he'll have a the staircase of clouds reappear so you guys can travel down and
travel down them.
Yes, right. With horses.
With horses.
And you're about an hour outside.
Walking down the stairs with horses. I'm gonna walk next to my horse.
Yeah, no,
I'm not riding on my horse.
Okay.
Yeah, we'll get down there.
All right. So you guys get to the bottom, no problem, and travel along the trail, and you seem to come across with the large outer gates of Waterdeep. So I should probably tell you, on your travels about 30 minutes in, you notice the wind starts to pick up a little bit more. It's a very hot wind, too.
Okay.
And it starts to drizzle a little bit, but the closer and closer you get to Waterdeep, the harder and harder it starts to rain. And once you get to the outer gates, it's really pouring, so people have got their cloaks up and they're, huddling together under the gates, or they're, running with horses, trying to get mm-hmm. them inside with their carts and covering up their goods.
Okay.
And guards are, shouting to people and, telling them where to go and how to go there.
Okay. So as it starts raining harder, I want to slowly start picking up speed, so that way we get into the city faster.
All right.
Yeah.
So you make it through the outer gates and the inner gates, and you enter, we'll say, the southern ward.
Sure.
The bar.
Yes.
And from there is only short distance to...
Dipstick.
Yeah. I am short dipstick. Short distance to the trade.
Yes, it's very close by. It's actually one ward up. Yes. And so you're able to do that. The city's, streets are pretty clear because it's pouring rain out.
Right.
There's some thunder and lightning out on the coast. But, you make it to the trade district all right.
All right. And
we need to find a place to sell all this stuff.
Yes, all of these. We're looking for, like, a pawn shop.
All right. So, you see, you know, regular shops, a little wand shop, a little alchemist shop, a blacksmith is actually working his forge out in the rain.
So,
this is good, but we have things to sell.
There's a general store. There's many different types of stores.
Good.
The general store?
I mean, we can start there and ask for a pawn shop.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Yeah.
We'll walk in out of the rain.
All right. You see a large guy with a giant afro. He's a human, and he's quite tall. And he's spinning a weird ball on his finger. And he's like, hi, how can I help you?
We have an assortment of goods we need to sell.
Ah, he'll put the ball down.
I mean, I don't know if you're in the market for any of this stuff or if you know someone that is, but...
What are you two selling?
Oh, we've got a bunch of things. We've got some armor that we can sell. We've got some gemstones, a whole bunch of different rings and necklaces. Do you have vials of oil for sale?
Yes, we do.
Oh, wonderful. Perhaps we'll make some purchases as well. Oh, we also have two copper dragon scales.
Oh, wow.
One copper, one gold. Oh, I kept the gold.
You got the gold.
I kept the gold.
Well, being that we're just like a general store, we don't take any like specialized items.
Oh, okay. Can I buy some oil, though?
Yes, you can.
Okay.
I would like 5 vials of oil, please.
All right, that'll be about 10 gold.
All right, wonderful.
Do you know of a place where we could sell some of these specialized items?
Actually, I do. You guys seem like you might want to go talk to Craftee O'Tastic down at the Witchcraft. He's
Craftee O'Tastic.
He's about a half a ward over. You would have to travel back to the southern ward. But he's a good friend of mine. You know, we hit up the pubs together a lot.
Wonderful. And what is your name, sir?
My name is Shaquille.
Shaquille?
Yes.
Very very nice to meet you.
Should we tell him that you sent us?
Yes, yes.
Shaquille sent us.
Yes. Him and I play dragon chess.
Ah.
Yes.
I hear if you practice against yourself, you make it better.
Hey.
Well, I wouldn't flood your mind with crazy things like that, but it's always good to play somebody else.
Ah, okay.
That's why we...
Extra set of eyes.
We play.
Makes sense.
Yes. See? Always have to have somebody watching your back.
Indeed. Indeed. All right, well, this storm doesn't seem to be getting any lighter, so we better get the move on.
No, and have you heard the news?
About the bird?
What bird are we talking about?
The bird is the... No, never mind.
Ah, okay. There's been some sightings of large ships off the coast of Waterdeep, more towards the Whalebones Islands.
Mm.
And they're very strange ships, things that we haven't seen in a very long time. And we think that they might be storm giants.
Oh.
Yes, and so we think that possibly that's why the weather is acting up.
Hmm. That's bad news.
Yes, especially because they're all the way, they were sighted all the way out at Whalebones, that potentially they could be closer.
Hmm. Yes, big ships like that would be hard to miss, except in storm, perhaps.
Yes.
Hmm.
But anyway, Craftee is he's your man. Dwarf, I should say. He's your dwarf.
All right, that makes sense. Thank you very much. Right. So as we walk out, throw my hood back up, and I'll turn to Ivellios and be like, perhaps we should go to the harbor at some point soon and see if I could embed one of their ships, perhaps one of the city's defense ships, if these storm giants are going to be an issue.
How long does that take again?
It takes an hour.
That's fine.
And as the door closes behind you, you hear like a couple thuds, and you hear a bouncing of a ball, and then you hear a slam, and there's boom,
Shaquille. Shakalaka.
Shaquille has seemed to have dunked the ball through some sort of
hole. Sphere?
Yeah, And that was above the door.
How big are his feet?
They're pretty large. Larger than you've ever seen.
It's a massive man.
Yes, very much so. I tell you what, let's take a trip to... You know what, let's go there. We'll go to Crafty's first, because I was going to go talk to the blacksmith, but maybe Craftee can hook us up with just armor that way.
Yeah, maybe. Also, and we don't have enough money for your plate mail right now.
No, but we'll see what we can come up with.
Yeah.
I also know a guy. As a criminal, I have a shady contact in every city.
Well, fantastic.
So, I haven't actually brought that up, but, you know, if we have to get rid of some stuff that's, like, 13 deeds to a town, probably not going to sell that on the up and up.
No, probably not.
But, yeah, I know a guy. Or I can find a guy.
All right.
So we'll head...
Do you know the guy already?
I don't know the guy.
Well, I can help you out with that if you want.
Yeah, that's fine. No, that's completely on you. Unless, yeah, unless we got some crazy random donation that gave me a guy, it's on you.
Yeah.
So
I don't have a guy. I just mostly steal from people.
That's fine. Well,
take what you need. You know, it's more for the fun.
Yeah, no. I mean, if I need it more, that's not stealing.
That's a good. I like that. I'm gonna keep that.
You can take that one.
That's going to be my new thing.
What if I need it more than they need it?
It's not stealing.
Exactly.
What if I want it more than they need it?
What if they're really annoying and then I kill them?
Oh.
That's murder. That's that's the worst of all crimes.
Huh. All right, Carl.
That's for you.
Thank you. So we're going to go ahead to Crafty. Come on, Strix. You're being very stoic. I know you don't like cities. Let's go.
Ah, ha, 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 ha. Oh, that was better.
Ah!
All right, so as you travel back down the southern ward...
I imagine him just standing, like, outside of the shop, like, not coming in. Just
it's in the pouring rain. He doesn't care.
Just doesn't care at all.
He's got his mouth open for a while.
People start walking by, he's like, ha ha ha.
He starts licking his lips and thinking of a weird eye.
He in a bag. I love Sean, that's great.
Eyeing people's fingers, right? Hungrily.
So,
it's finger food. Anyway, sorry.
So, yeah. So, it's actually kind of hard to find the witchcraft. Mm-hmm. So, I'm going to say that you guys maybe... ask some people when you went about a half a ward down.
Right. Hail you people. Hail you people.
Yes, yes, a woman will come up to you. Yes.
I need to find my child. Oh, wonderful. I need to find a shop. It's called the Witchcraft.
Oh, yes. It's about three streets over.
Three streets over.
You're going to see an alley on the right-hand side.
Okie doke.
It's very... very hidden. Okay. You're going to go down that alley. You'll see the sign once you go down the alley.
Fantastic.
Thank you.
So you guys go down there. You go down the alley.
Down the alley.
You see the sign. It's just blowing in the breeze. It says the witchcraft. There's a door. And there's no windows like on the main street, but when you hit the side street, you can see into the shop.
Nice.
See some different items in there.
It's a shop.
It's a shop.
Open the door.
I knock as I open the door. Just as like, coming in.
Just letting you know, just in case.
Alright, so as you go in, you see a red-haired shield dwarf. He's got a thick dark amber beard that's been braided. You can tell it's spent years near the embers of a forge. And he's got rosy red cheeks, and when he smiles and greets you, he has a bottom row of teeth that are all gold, and in those teeth you see rubies and sapphires that have been engraved into his teeth.
Wow.
That's fantastic.
Okay, we'll say, hello! Welcome to my shop. I am Craftee O'Tastic.
Wonderful to meet you.
What can I do for you?
We were actually hoping to sell some things.
Shaquille sent us.
Oh, Shaq. My man. And he's saying, whatever, if Shaq has brought you here to me today, then I will help you.
That's fantastic. You are a wonderful person.
You are very lucky. He's well known around Waterdeep. I don't know if you knew that.
No, I didn't.
Oh.
No.
The more you know.
The more you know.
Knowledge is power. Knowing's half the battle.
So, gentlemen, what are you here to sell?
We have 3 vials of perfume to start.
What kind of perfume?
This one's lilac.
Oh.
This one's lavender, and this one is blue.
I'd like those for my wife, please.
Okay. I'll sell you for 5 gold each.
Sounds fine.
Wonderful. Second, we have the symbol of Asmodeus. He's the god.
Oh, Asmodeus.
Asmodeus.
What do you know?
Indeed.
Oh. And what kind of symbol?
It's just like a holy symbol.
Is it metal? Is it wood?
It's ivory.
Ivory, okay.
75 gold?
That looks like something I'd have on my bookshelf. I'd give you 15 gold for it.
Oh. 40 gold.
20.
20 is not reasonable.
I have nicer things than
that. Alright, how about that symbol and this locket, which is in the shape of it's a wooden locket with a boot, and it opens up. Maybe you could put the picture in there, or like engrave something. I don't know. Something valuable. 60
it's
gold
wood?
For the two of them.
It's wood?
Yes, but it's finely crafted wood.
May I?
Mm-hmm.
Takes a look at it. Natural 20. This is the finest crafting. He hands it back. We've got a deal.
All right.
Thanks. My wife's going to be a happy lady.
Indeed. Gemstones.
Well, I could always use gemstones.
Who
in
can't use
in,
that?
In my artificing?
Yep.
I've got 10. 10 of them.
And how much?
They're ETH worth. They're worth 100 gold each.
I'll be the judge of that.
Yes, you can tell. I can tell anyway.
Yeah, so they look about that.
Yeah, wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. Mm. We've got these two. Oh, wait, no, we want to keep these two. The snake rings.
Keep those
in my
rings
pocket
for now.
But we have this wonderful jewelry box, these 3 necklaces, and this ring here. The ring, beautiful. Set with different gemstones. Your wife might love it. You also might sell it for more or imbue it with, I don't know, magical properties. I don't know anything about it. But I do know that it's worth at least 900 gold. Perhaps more.
This looks like a ring that I saw at a party once. I think Shaq had a date. Lady Valrosa?
Hmm.
Never heard of her.
It looks a lot like her ring.
Unusual.
Well, I'll tell you what. I'll give you 2,000 gold for everything you got there.
Deal.
All right. It just so happens I have an empty display case here I've been looking to fill up with miscellaneous things. You can't give your wife everything.
No.
But we all try.
Gotta make a business.
You gotta make a business, thank you. Yeah. You gotta put food on the table first.
Oh, what about these 2 copper dragon scales? We found them in a cave.
Oh yes. I could, you could probably make something out of that.
Something magical.
Yeah,
perhaps.
You?
Like what?
Yeah. With those scales, I could add them to armor, add some magical qualities to them, perhaps. They work well with gems, and I have a couple of those now.
How much would something like that be worth to you?
He strokes his beard.
I stroke my ear.
I stroke my ice blue stubble. It's so not painful.
We're all sitting here stroking ourselves.
Yes. Well.
As our lizard friend is outside eating that, like, in the window, like...
Well, you know, I had a better idea.
Alright.
I could mount these scales to the bottom of a sword, and they would help you in slaying dragons.
I have a sword.
Oh, yes?
Yeah, look at
see it.
Look at this one right here.
It's rapier, huh?
It is.
No, it couldn't be a rapier.
Oh, well, never mind then.
How about a...
I don't deal with rapiers.
No?
No.
Was he? Did he take shillelagh? No, he uses his claws.
Or magic rocks.
Yeah, because I was going to say, like, a scimitar, because he could use a scimitar. Can you use a scimitar? No, short sword. He's a short sword. Well, I made my sword.
Yeah. I don't got the magic sword already. It's made I would, of, it is magic.
I could. We could add it to it, but at that point, I don't know if one item could reasonably hold that much magic and still be... The balance of power in the weight of the blade would be a little bit too much to also add an additional amount of damage versus dragons. Be a little too much.
Mm.
But if
I see what you're saying, yes.
But if that is a thing that you could sell to other people, well, I think we'd be willing to
perhaps part with that. Trade that for services?
Yeah. Do you make armor by any chance? I need
to do.
In need
do
of an upgrade.
Oh, gloves, yes. By I do. Any chance. Yes.
Alright.
Yes, I have many items, and you see in his shop, you see amulets, you see a couple armors, you see like an adamantine armor set, you have another set next to it, but it's got a little bit more engraving in it. What seems to be... What languages do you guys know?
Giant and Draconic.
Elven, Dwarven, and Undercommon.
Ah, see, in a language you don't really understand, you see some writing on it, scripted in. You see a couple swords. You see, what else?
No rapiers, though.
A couple belts, in a case, a mace.
What kind of, what kind of belts? Magic belts?
Oh, my belts?
Yes.
Oh, these are different giant belts, granting strength.
Wonderful. Well, this is your part of the conversation.
Yeah, well, I'm going to go look at some of the armors and...
You see almost a see-through shield hanging on the wall.
All right, I'm going to start with the...
Armor.
The armors and say... I'm looking for plate, so I'll tell you that, but I'm just asking him... So any of the ones that were plate mail, I'm curious what they are and how much they cost and if we can make a little bit of a trade.
This armor here next to adamantine, this is demon armor.
And the adamantine, was the adamantine plate mail?
Yes.
Sean can use maces, but he uses his claws, I keep forgetting. All these good weapons we could have made for him, and he doesn't use any of them.
Nah, that's okay.
Alright, so aside from the adamantine armor, what else you got?
Let's see.
I mean, it doesn't have to be. I mean, I sort of already eyed that myself.
Any magic studded leather armor?
No, I don't have any of that.
Kill him and steal it. It's raining. It's raining really hard. No one will hear it.
Oh,
the streets barely have anyone there. It's the perfect crime.
It's the perfect crime. Wow.
Don't want to meet his wife.
It's you know what?
Did we kill him in one round? Is the question.
We killed the unicorn. No. Well, here's the thing. I still have that gold dragon scale, which, if he's interested in the copper, I imagine the gold would be even more interesting.
Ah. Katie, shh!
So I'd be willing to pony that up for a cut on some armor, probably. But I'd also, there's a lot of cool stuff here, so.
Yeah. You also see a brooch. You see some boots. They seem to have some fur on them. Some
boots
ice
with the fur. Boots with the fur.
I like these boots. I don't have any shoes.
Shaq loved those boots. Let me tell you.
What are those boots?
There any jeans where the buttocks is shaped like an apple to go along? Like you could
with the boots with the fur.
To go with the boots.
Shaq's
with the fur.
Shaq's wife bought those.
Ah, damn it.
But these are the boots of the Winterlands, and these are the boots of striding and springing. This is the brooch of shielding. And he's got all sorts of belts of giants. He says this is the belt of stone giant. This is the belt of frost giant. This is the belt of fire giant. And so forth.
Alright. Well.
This is the mace of smiting. These are gauntlets of ogre power. This is the dwarven thrower. This is the dragon slayer. This is my dwarven plate. Unfortunately, that's not for sale. This is...
Fair, he is dwarven.
These, you'll take them out, are dimensional shackles. Puts them back.
How much are those?
Those are super nice. You need them for fighting any kind of demon. Can't plane shift or teleport if you're shackled with those. No misty stepping out of my grapples on that, Jake. Cute, man. Every time.
These are going for about 10,000 gold.
That's fair.
Alright. What about... So he had adamantine armor, plate mail, and he had demon armor.
Plate mail.
How much for the adamantine armor?
Yes.
This is going to be about 3,000 gold.
That seems a little steep. I think that's probably worth... I mean, if I throw in these two dragon scales, where are we at?
You gotta play me in chess.
What was your intelligence?
Either one of you. You play me in a good game of chess. This is how I settle.
I'm who proficient I deal with. In chess. As a criminal, I have proficiency in chess, or gaming sets, so... All
right. So he breaks out a beautiful board. It's all marble. All pieces are marble. What'd you get, Ted?
22.
All right, you win. He says, well...
That's good. That's a good... How do you play?
I'll teach you. We got days of travel. I'll teach you how to play.
He'll say... Pass the time. I'll give it to you for 2,000 gold.
What if... Throw on a gold dragon scale. On top of the copper dragon. I mean, the rarest and most powerful of the chromatic... Or the metallic dragons.
And it seemed to be a huge gold dragon. This is a sizable scale.
That's true. It was a huge gold dragon. So I heard from you.
Yeah, because there was
and from a divine marsh.
And also the size of the scale.
I mean, this could be a shield for a halfling.
This could almost That's be like a new idea. Buckler for me. My shield is small.
This guy just creamed his pants at the thought of a gold dragon scale.
1,000 gold. It's a good deal.
It is a good deal. Oh no, those are your salted pepper shakers.
Oh, we can sell those. I was kidding.
Oh, okay.
I mean, that was a funny joke I made.
It was a funny joke. Yeah, I think that's a more than reasonable price.
All right, so we'll go for that. I've got 300 gold here. Oh. If you want to toss that into the mix.
Okay.
With 1,000. Just tell me what I'm at. You know what? Let's finish our sales and then we'll see where we're at.
We'll figure it out at the end. Okay.
That shield, the clear one.
Mm.
Just curious. We got a couple of shield users.
This is an animated shield.
Alright.
All right. So when using it. While holding the shield, you can speak its command word as a bonus action to cause it to animate. The shield leaps into the air and hovers in your space to protect you as if you were wielding it. Leaving your hands free, the shield remains animated for 1 minute until you use a bonus action to end this effect, or until you are incapacitated or die, at which point the shield falls to the ground or into your hand if you have a free one.
Huh. I could climb while having the shield going. Would be wonderful.
I can also wield a greatsword and have the bonus of a shield. it's
fair. Would that be?
10,000 gold.
Hmm.
Yeah.
Wow.
You know what? You two are pretty cool. And that guy outside, you can tell him to come in too.
Kind of like point and be like, and I'll be like.
I don't know what it is about the three of yous, but I got a good feeling.
Alright.
And he's going to lead you, he's going to open up his thing that you can go behind the counter, and he's going to open up a back door, he's going to bring you into a back room. And in this back room, there is this large, crazy machine, and it's huge. It's like an iron barrel, weighs 500 pounds.
And wow.
It's called the apparatus of Wallish. Oh. And he's like, I've made this thing myself. What do you think?
This is pretty impressive.
This is a feat of engineering, the likes of which I've never seen. I'm sorry I don't sound excited, but I don't do excited.
It's alright. I
am very excited. is wondrous.
I've been working on it for quite some time, ever since this whole thing about giants has been going about, and
seems reasonable.
Being that storm giants are the biggest of them all, you gotta be prepared to go anywhere.
Hey, you're in my chair!
Anything. Shh. You've just come into the shop.
As in-game. You were just invited into
I just
into
invited
the
you
shop.
In.
Oh, I'm gonna get a beer first.
That's all right. Fine.
So yeah.
There's some dog pee. Does anyone want something from the beer room?
I don't think it's dog pee. I think it's ginger ale, maybe?
No.
Because you had the bottles on the floor.
But it was empty.
It was standing up, too.
Yeah, maybe.
So that was a no overall?
Yeah, good.
Yes.
We're good.
No, thank you.
Yeah. And he's like,
you're right there, champ?
I don't know if you guys have heard, but King Hecaton has gone missing.
Ooh.
We had
heard that. So does that mean you might give us the shield?
Shield? You want to buy the shield?
I cast guidance.
Can I put a down payment on it? And I mean, we met the giant, and he wants us to help him fix what's going on with the giants.
Really?
Yeah. His name was Zephyros.
Huh.
He was a very cool magic guy. Anyway, he's got a flying
what
castle.
What kind of giant was he? Flying giant cloud giants.
Exactly. So he's like, hey, I think you guys are the guys. And we're like, of course we're the guys. Look at us.
That's crazy because we're small folk.
Yes, but look at this. I've got this storm giant room on my
Uvar.
Uvar.
Yes. Yeah, speak giant.
Oh, me too. Hey.
Craftee O'Tastic.
Oh, cool.
So, hello.
So we need the shield, man, and I will give you the rest of the gold that we have.
How much is that?
It was 2,390 and 2 platinum and 105 silver.
Well, before we put the down payment on that, did you want to see the other things that were here first, if there was anything else
worth getting?
Now, but before, perhaps Boots of the Winterland before we travel to Icewind Dale.
Oh, that's a good point. That is a very good point. We'd like both, ideally. Maybe we could come back
later. And
then
while he's looking at the figuring out the prices, I go, so listen, we have just a ball of unicorn hair. Why don't we just tell him that we killed some ogres that had killed a unicorn? And we brought what we had so that this wouldn't go to waste. We have unicorn hair. We have unicorn blood. I got a 5.
I got a 5.
But
guidance.
But maybe he can use the tensile strength of unicorn hair to help move the hydraulic mechanisms in his apparatus of Gualish to strengthen it, because he's still working on it.
Right.
And maybe this will help. I don't know, but I'll throw it out there. Because if that helps, we help him, maybe he helps us. Maybe we don't get the shield right now, but maybe we pick up... I mean, I'm...
Does he walk back into the room?
No, he's standing with you.
Oh.
Well, this was off to the side.
Yeah.
Like, well, he's... Because we're not telling him this out loud. This was like a...
Right.
We're going to have this conversation. We're just talking to Dad about down payments and things. Have our conversation.
Right. Okay, so then we walk back to him.
Yes.
So, how much for those there boots?
2,000 gold.
2,000 gold for the boots. Okay. Well, we've got some other magical materials, which you may be interested in.
Hmm.
They're not your average fare.
No?
Oh, tell me about these. I mean, you've given me a gold dragon scale, so,
It's hard to move up from there.
Yeah.
And we're moving perpendicular.
Huh. If he doesn't go for that, my guy might go for that. My shady criminal contact, who we're going to sell the deeds
to. So we've got this, unicorn hair. Took it off the mane and the tail of a unicorn that had been slain by its lair. So, we had to...
Slain by what?
We happened upon the body shortly after. It seemed like there were some tracks, but we couldn't follow them through the woods. There was a storm, similar to this. And then we came across the town of Nightstone. And then we ended up dealing with the people there.
And what happened in Nightstone?
There were people. They were captured from their town.
If you go back, please send Lady Valrosa my regards.
Oh, yes, sure. No problem. But anywho, so we've got the unicorn hair, which might be something that you might be interested in for its tensile strength or other magic properties.
Of course, yes.
But definitely tensile strength.
Yes.
It's a giant ball of hair, which is like a giant ball of string, which is makes me remiss to sell it. So
he's got a minor illusion to red dot behind him.
And
he's gonna stop it.
Okay.
I just had to. You were talking about a ball of yarn, so
yeah.
I just had to see if the stereotype stuck. You know what I mean?
Yes. Anyway,
we have fun here.
So the boots and the shield. So we'll give you the 2,000 gold and this unicorn hair.
For the shield?
No, for the
boots.
The boots.
I'm sorry.
And the shield. Because we have the money for the boots, but for the shield, the unicorn hair. Which would be
what's the shield?
An animated
I'll
shield.
Give you the boots for the hair.
Okay.
And 5,000 for the shield.
We don't have that much money.
That's a good deal.
Is that the standing offer?
Yes.
Alright.
He's beat me in chess. He can come back anytime.
I'm actually proficient in chess. So solid plan. That's actually worked out.
Yeah.
Alright.
So I was gonna ask Pat if I can get something other than that, but now I'm glad I didn't.
Yeah.
Is this good?
He plays in a
5,000
with his friend Shaquille with a big afro.
Ooh.
Very tall.
Shaquille.
Alright. Wonderful. So I'll trade him the unicorn hair. And we'll keep our other gold for now. I can't even think of, Wait, what do the boots of striding do? And jumping and leaping and whatever.
They up your stride to 30 and you can jump 30 or 3 times your movement speed.
Yeah. If your speed was less than 30,
right.
It makes it 30.
Okay.
And then it triples your jump.
Hmm. Which is neat.
Yeah.
But.
Boots of the Winterland were definitely the better call. I mean, he had belts of every type of giant strength, too. But I didn't even bother because. I think that's a little bit out of our price range.
Probably. Except for the ones that are, you know, lower than your strength, anyway.
I'm 20, so we're talking upper tier at this point at the minimum.
I mean, if we ever find gauntlets of ogre power, I'd be down for that.
He has them. You weren't here because we were like... here's the thing. He has gauntlets of ogre power.
Mm-hmm.
He told us that he could take the dragon scales.
This is what he has. He
could take the dragon scales and make a dragon slayer... sword,
but she already has one. Cool.
Yeah.
So
we were like,
it's not a rapier.
It's not a rapier.
No leather armor.
No.
This guy's like, I go metal.
He's an artificer. He's a dwarf. It makes sense. We could have made a scimitar out of that, which you could use. He didn't want a short sword, and I was like, I can't have a dragon slayer on top of this sword. It's too much.
Yeah, it's hard
for me. Like, it's not fair to anyone. Specifically dragons.
Fair.
Where was that cave?
6d8 plus 46 plus 68 plus 2 3 68 plus 5d6 on a regular hit
and crit on a 19 or 20
and crit on a 19 or 20 yeah, too much. He also had maces, magic maces, which you can use a mace, but we were like, oh, you
can
use your claws, so we're like,
the gauntlets would primarily be for my bite.
He also
I wanted to bite something, I could bite something.
Yeah, he also has the stone giant, hill giant strength. Hill giant is 21.
Okay.
So it's like the lowest tier.
Yeah.
He also had like all the way up to like frost and fire, which would be bananas.
Yeah.
But
I don't have that.
But gauntlets of ogre power are only uncommon, so they're not like crazy.
How much for your fancy metal gloves?
1,000 gold.
Fair enough.
Fuck. That sucks. I didn't even think about that.
Yeah. I didn't until you said your
fancy
metal
gloves.
It sounds like,
hey the architect.
I gotta put, and then I drink it. Well, then I'm good.
Alright, so.
Never
he also had amulets and cloaks and a brooch of shielding.
Oh, cool.
I don't have any money.
Yeah, I know.
And we didn't, like...
Yeah.
Yeah. So, I'm good.
All right. So, we'll be back for the shield.
I'm just here with my D4.
At a later date.
And you're going to hear a ding! And he's going to... Excuse me, one second. And he's going to open up this little compartment, and steam is going to come out. He's going to pull out a tray of fish. He's going to put it on the table. He's just going to eye everybody. And there's four fish there. And they're good-sized fish. So normally, I can eat two and then bring some home, but if anybody wants fish, it's there.
All right.
Then he'll take it and start eating.
I'll take one.
People don't really come to my shop, so when they do, you know, when they do business.
Take a fish, it's delicious. Am I poisoned?
He's gonna pick it up.
Yeah. Does my cat detect poison?
Throw it to you.
I'm going to attempt to catch it in my big reptile mouth.
Right. Big athletics check.
I grabbed the wrong character sheet.
Oh.
So I think my athletics is a one.
Alright.
I grabbed PPOP.
With guidance.
I didn't cast it on myself.
True.
I'm I'm trying to be honest, but yeah, because how.
Always catch
an 11. An 11.
You catch it.
Oh, yeah.
You have a large mouth. You can grab it.
And it's not poison, says the tressum.
The fish?
Yeah.
No.
All right, cool.
But it is delicious.
I'll have some fish too. Mm-hmm. Then.
All right. Well, thank you. I guess that we will. Be on our way then.
Mm.
We got to make a quick stop by the docks. You guys want anything else from here?
No, thanks. I'm full.
Thank you for your business. We'll be back when we. Well, may be a little while, but we'll be back.
Right. It's downpouring outside.
Yeah.
You were just standing out in the rain, just
drinking
like,
rain and eating bats.
Awesome.
Ah, ha ha ha! People.
Yeah,
that's what
yeah.
we described you
ah,
as. These people are like running through the downpour. You're just standing outside whatever store we were in.
They seemed upset, so I laughed, as that is what one does.
Ha 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 ha.
Ah.
Ha.
Ha
ha. Wonderful.
I like your style.
Before we head to the docks, perhaps we should talk to my guy.
Ah, your fellow.
Yes.
What's your guy's name?
It just goes by M.
M?
Yep.
Are you sure it's not W?
Weast.
No. It's M. I got an organization. He's part of an organization.
Alright.
So, let's see if we can't,
You would know this organization to have their own boat.
Oh, they're down by the docks. Never mind. Let's go do that.
Great.
You happen to be like half a word over.
Great, let's head over. We're going to the docks anyway.
Cut it here, and then we'll get back in the other way. We did probably, we did all of our selling, and now we've just
Well, we didn't sell the
the other parts of the unicorn.
And all of the 13 deeds to Nightstone.
Yeah, so we've still got, some of our shopping to do, but
yeah.
I think that might be a good spot to.
Sure.
We've been going for about an hour now, so.
Well, we were upstairs making coffee while Pat sat here working with the stream on for a little while.
Nice.
Yep.
Okay.
Yeah, that's fine.
All right, cool. So.
Cut.
All right, guys, we are going to probably take just a short break while Sean gets stuff set up, and then we'll jump into Out of the Abyss.
And you're going to have to move the camera.
Yeah, a little bit.
Oh, yeah, no, it just zoomed in.
Yeah, I know. Oh.
Yeah, we zoomed
in.
Oh,
is that new? Is that the new one?
Yeah.
Nice.
It is fancy.
Yeah.
Isn't it?
Oh, my butt. We'll just do this because...
They did the boss battle and they lost to the snakes.
Look at snakes! Awesome.
Just zoomed it out.
Oh yeah, look at that. It still looks cool.
Yeah, I know.
Fancy.
That's way better.
Yeah, I just got. All
right, guys, we will be right back.